हेलो बच्चों, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फ्रॉम आवर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम वर्कशीट. ओके, इट इज एमसीक्यू वर्कशीट दैट आई ऑलरेडी गेव. ओके, सो टेक दैट वर्कशीट एंड से द क्वेश्चन. सो वी विल डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. ओके, सो सी हियर इन क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, एन आइटम विद एटॉमिक नंबर 18, okay, at mass number 40, so have the following arrangement. See small a option, 18 proton, 18 electron, 22 neutron, 18 proton, 18 electron, 40 neutron, okay, small b option, small c, 22 proton. So see here, 80, atomic number 18 means, yes, how many your proton? Yes, 18 your proton only. Okay, thereafter electron, so number of proton is equal to number of electron. Okay, so here 18 electron, understood. So atomic mass, so mass they give 40, so beta here. Okay, so mass number, what will be the formula for question number one? Mass number, number of proton plus number of neutron. Yes, 18 plus 22, so how much here you will get? 40, understood. So your option is what? Small a option, understood. So like that, here we have to solve this simple questions. Okay, so we will discuss here question number second. Okay, so in that question number second, say which of the following species are isoelectronic? Isoelectronic in question number 2, isoelectronics. So isoelectronic species means what? Same number of electron. Iso means same, similar. Okay, so see here, in option A what they give? H2O and H2S. Okay, so see here number of electron for hydrogen is 2, okay, but oxygen and sulfur is a different, so this option is wrong here. Now see small b option. Okay, small b option we will check. NO3 minus, CO3 2 minus. Okay, so see here how we can calculate here number of electrons. Okay, so say 7, number of electrons in nitrogen 7 plus your oxygen 8, atomic number 8, so it is 24. So 7 plus 24 plus 1, how much? 32 electrons for your, yes, for your nitrate ion, and for your carbonate ion, that is CO3 2 minus carbon 6 plus oxygen here 24, 8 3 the 24 plus 2, yes, how much you will get? Yes, you will get how much? 32 electrons only. Okay, so here your option is what? Small b. Okay, it is your correct option here. Now we will discuss question number 3. So in question number 3, say what they give here. In question number 3, which of the following statements are correct? Which of the following statements are correct? So say in that small a, nitrogen 714 and C613 are isotones. Small b, in nitrogen 714 and C614 are isotopes. Okay, option C, in nitrogen 714 and C612 are isobars, and nitrogen 147 and C15 are isotones. So here simply clearly visible, we will check small a option. Nitrogen 7, so see here, nitrogen 7 and here 14, and what beta here? Carbon 6 and what? 13. So isotones means what? Number of neutrons. Isotones means what? Same number of, yes, same number of what? Neutrons. is what your isotones. Okay, so if you are considering this, so 7 plus 7 14. Okay, so see proton plus neutron. Now here what, 6 plus 7 is also 13, means here same number of neutrons here also, means here also 7 and here also 7. So beta, here what, same number of neutrons. So your A only option is correct for question number 3. Understood? So like that, simple questions are there. Now we will discuss question number 4. Okay, so we will discuss question number 4. When atoms of gold sheet are bombarded by beam of alpha particles, only few alpha particles goes deflected, whereas most of them go straight undeflected. This is because, so say small a, the force of attraction of alpha particle by the oppositely charged electron is not sufficient. Not it is wrong it is. So say the number of small b, the nucleus occupies much smaller volume as compared to the total volume of atom. Yes, the nucleus, whatever your nucleus, occupies much smaller volume as compared to total volume of the atom. Okay, so beta, here your small b option only correct. Okay, so your question, small b, your option is correct. Understood? So now see question number 5. So in question number 5, the number of d electrons, so carefully, achieve than the nisper, the number of d electrons in Fe2+, number of d electrons, okay, this according to our advanced concept SPDF we saw. Okay, the number of d electrons in Fe2+, Z is equal to atomic number they gave 26, is equal to that of, is equal to, okay, is equal to that of, so say question, the option also they gave, p electrons in neon 10, s electrons in mg 12, say option d electrons in fe, and what, yes, p electrons in cl. okay, so see here, whatever d electrons in Fe2+, okay, so beta, d electrons in Fe2+, see here, for that we must know here, okay, we must know here whatever electronic configuration for scandium to zinc, means up to we saw, see here, I will revise that. Whatever according to advanced concept we saw here, see, as you know, say this, your calcium, okay, say from potassium we will start. So potassium 19, yes, so how we can write, we can take help of argon 18, yes, argon 18, then what, 4s1, understood? And here with a calcium 20, okay, say means 18 plus 1 19, and here what would I, argon 18, yes, what will come, 4s2, means, and if you are considering, or if you can check whatever your K, potassium and calcium, these are what here, s block elements, okay. So which one last electron received in which subshell, that is your what, block, understood? Or we can say group number also, see, for S1, group number 1, in group number 1 only your potassium is present, and in group 2 only here calcium is present, in S block group 1, in S block group 2, okay, so they are indicating group number also, okay. Understood? So very much interesting these are. Now you understood this 4s1. Now we have to take, suppose you, if you have this periodic table in front of you, so you can check from 21 to 30. So that now we are going to discuss here, advanced electronic configuration for that. Okay, so say carefully, you say here, okay, in question number 5, say scandium scandium 21, then what? Titanium, palladium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper and Zn. What beta? Zinc, Zn. Now see here, scandium 21, so here what? 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. This we want now for question number 5. 27, 28, 29 and 30. Okay, so see here, scandium to what beta? Zinc means one mantras I told to how to memorize this whatever your first transition series. Okay, D block your first transition series. So see here, skati vakra mana fekuni kunjana. What beta? Skati vakra mana fekuni kunjana. Understood? See, it is one of the important mantra, and for memorizing this first transition series, it is useful. Okay. Now see, we have to write here beta electron configuration. Okay. So we have to write here outermost electron configuration only. So see here, no need to all that 1s2 2s2 p6 3s2 3p6. It is already we covered in our organ 18. So no need to write. Only we have to take help of your our organ 18. So see here first. Okay. Here beta organ 18 is common. Whatever your argon 18 is common. Understood? Argon 18 is common. So now after that you have to write, so say 3d1 4s2 for your scandium. So what will come for this titanium? So see, we can cross check 18 plus 1 19 plus 2 21. Okay, now see here, we can write for titanium. So what we can write? 3d2 4s2. Yes, 3d2 4s2. We can cross check 18 plus 2 20 plus 2 22. So vanadium what will come beta? 3d3 4s2. We can cross check. Now see what will come for chromium. Yes, for chromium what will come? 3d4 4s2. But here exceptional case is there. Okay, so that concept of what half filled and full filled are vital. And for your kind information, half filled and full filled are more stable. Okay, so as you know beta, for your d orbitals, so total 5 blocks are there. So number of electrons how much in each orbital? 2. So total 10. So like that, say here, this is your what? Yes, this is your what? D block. And I already told there are types also, dxy, dyz, dz, dx square, dz square. So see here, first singly field 1 2 3 4 5, then what? 6 7 8 9 10. Okay, means first what beta? Single field, so 5. Or we can write what? D5. And after fulfilling of another, means first single field and pairing takes place, then after that how much it will complete it? D5 D10. So these are both are what? Both are more stable. Okay, if you are considering among these two, so D10 fulfilled is more stable. But here beta, here, so see here what will happen. Whatever this 4 is, one of the electron is shifted to D sub shell. So what we come means you are getting here, you will get here, means one of the electron from 4a sub shell is shifted to where? D sub shell. Because what? Because for stability, to give, to attain stability. Or chemistry mein stability ke liye kuch bhi ho sakta hai. Understood? So see here, D5 D10, I already told here. So see, your modern electron configuration. So what you will get here? 3D5, yes, 4S1. Understood. So after that, you have to take this electronic configuration only, not this. Okay. So this thing will happen for chromium and copper. Okay. Means for your among these first transistors, your what? This chromium and copper, these are what exceptional cases. For what? To achieve stability. Understood? Okay. So see, next beta. For manganese, yes. 3D5 4S2, you can cross check. Argon 18 is constant here, so 18 plus 5 23 plus this 2 25, so atomic number also match. Understood? So see here, next 3D6 4S2, so that we want for a question, so you will get here. So what is that in question? The number of d electrons in Fe2+. Okay, so that also we will discuss. First we will write all. So see, 3D7 4S2 for cobalt. Okay, advance this electron configuration, advance theory. In higher standard you have to study this only. Okay, up to 8 standard, as I told, 2881, 2882, that you have to discuss. Okay, now say for nickel, 3D8 4S2. Okay. Now for your copper, yes, beta 3D9 4S2, but as like same here regarding chromium, what will happen? See, 9 is closest to what? Stability. So one of the electron is shifted to where? In D subshell, so it becomes what? Modern 3D10. 4S1, or we can say modified electronic configuration. Understood? And whatever you are saying, 3D10 4S2, so very much important. Okay, very much important is all. Understood? So now we will concentrate on our question. See here, the number of d electrons in Fe2+, so we can observe easily here, beta. So see, your iron 26, so for this how much? Yes, 3D6 4S2, no need to take again and again that argon 18. Okay, one outer electron configuration only you take, it is also okay. Now beta, for Fe2+, what will happen? See here, Fe2+, this whatever your outermost shell, this electron will go out. Dissociate. Fe2+ means auto minus. So what you will get, electronic configuration becomes, yes, electronic configuration becomes 3D6 4S0. Got my point here? So beta, in Fe2+ we got here 3D6, so number of d electrons in Fe2+ is equal to that of, now we have to cross check our options. So can we? So once you got this information, so I hope you all understood this. Okay, 3D subshell with the 4S. Okay, very much important. You note down all this. Okay, so now we will concentrate on our question. Which means 6 electrons in where? In which? Whatever they gave in option, the number of d electrons in Fe2+. So beta, number of d electrons. Now in question number 5 we are discussing number of d electrons. Okay, number of d electrons how much here? Yes, 6 electrons are there. Okay, is equal to that of, so see, small a, p electrons in neon 10. So we can cross check. So see, neon atomic number 10, so 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Okay, so say 2p6. So beta, in p subshell 6 electrons are there, so you will get our option also, 6 electron in your p electrons in neon 10. Yes, p electrons in neon 10, so you will get answer. So your option is what? Small a. Understood? So for this I wrote all. Okay, whatever your from scandium to zinc, atomic number 21 to 30, you must revise that all, very, very much important. Okay. So you got this question. Now we will discuss question number 6. In question number 6, Rutherford alpha particle scattering experiment lead to the discovery of, everyone knows, lead to the discovery of what? Nucleus. So small a option. Next, so question number 7. These are 4 elements, P, Q, R and S, having atomic number 4, 8, 10 and 16. Respectively, the element which can exhibit covalency as well as electrovalency. Okay, covalency as well as electrovalency. So see here, your option here, small d. Your option here, what? Small d. Because, see, your sulfur, atomic number 16 is what? Sulfur. Okay, so their electronic configuration 2, 8, 6. Okay, so beta, they want 2 electrons to complete its octet. So whatever these two, are what? Electrovalency as well as covalency of that sulfur. Okay, whatever bonding pair. So see, suppose if you are considering H2S, H2S, suppose you are writing H2S. So say like this, H2S. These are what beta? Here structure of this means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This octet also completed. 2 lone pairs are there on your sulfur, and these are what? Bond pairs. So hydrogen duplet also completed. This 8 electron and hydrogen always they are forming how much? Yes, 2 electrons. Okay, so electrovalency and covalency for your sulfur is how much? Yes, total 2 only. Okay, covalency and electrovalency. So option will look what? D, that is sulfur. Now see here, next we will discuss question number 8. Okay, so in question number 8, on adding neutron, on adding neutron to the nucleus of an atom, changes will be observed in its, so automatically changes will observed in where? Mass number. In mass number. Okay, adding neutron means what? Changes will occur in mass number. So question number 9. Isotopes of an element have different number of neutrons. Yes, what beta? Different number of neutrons. Okay, 10. See, which of the following is the maximum number of unpaired electrons? So maximum number of unpaired electrons means, see here, unpaired means what? Singly paired, unpaired. Okay, so see in question number 10, maximum number of unpaired electrons. See, so we will cross check here one by one. Ti 3 plus, then what beta? Small b, what they gave? V. Yes, V 3 plus. Okay, V 3 plus. Small c, what beta? Fe 2 plus. And small d. Yes, small d, what beta? Fe 3 plus. Understood. So we have to write electronic configuration according to advanced concept, because these are what? Transition element they give. So it is for your competitive, not for your regular or NCID. Okay, these are what beta? Additional concepts, and for higher standard it is very, very much important. Okay, so see, we will discuss. So as you must know beta, the atomic number at least 30. So scutty, so 22. So beta, normal is what? Normal titanium is what? Like this, 3d2, 4s2. Yes, normal electron configuration 3d2, 4s2. But for beta, here for Ti3 plus ion, yes, for Ti3 plus ion, for now these two electrons will go out, and one, this one electron also goes Okay, so what you will get? 3d1, 4h0. So how many number will ignore? One only. Okay, so see here, vanadium's ka T vakra, so 23. So beta here, 3d3, 4h2, it is the original vanadium. So V3 plus means what? For V3 plus, one of these two electrons will go outside and from this one electron. So total 3. So 3d2, 4h0. Understood. So here one electron, here two. We want a maximum unpaired electron. Okay. So Fe2 plus, yes, 26. For normal Fe, how much? 3d6, 4h2. For Fe2 plus, these two electrons will go out. Okay. So see as like this. Understood. So say, Fe2 plus, how we can write, beta? 3d6, these two electron goes out, 3d6, 4h0. Okay, now atomic number 26. So, as you know, normal original iron and for now Fe3 plus has like this 3d5, 4h0 because these two and one of these one electron will goes out. Understood? So, now we will draw here block diagram for this. Now, as you know, D subshell. Okay, D subshell, as you know. So we can, so see here, beta. Now we will start to draw here. Okay, so see, according to our D subshell, are you concentrating? Yes, see here. How many D? One unpaired electrons. Yes, you're how much? One unpaired electron. So for this, yes, again I have to draw this what D subshell here as like this 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So 1, 2 unpaired electrons. You are concentrating. Now see here. Okay. See beta. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 unpaired electrons. See, with the help of whatever our first singly field, Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. First singly field, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So here, beta, pairing takes place. So number of how much? 1, 2, 3, 4. So here, beta, 1, 2, 3, 4 unpaired electrons. Got my point here. Now see regarding your Fe3 plus inner D subshell 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So see 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for D subshell. How much? 5. Here 4. So your option is what, beta? Your D option is correct here. So maximum number of electrons, maximum unpaired electrons, unpaired. Pairing not. Paired means like this. Understood? So very much important this concept. Okay. That's why I took here for you video solutions. Okay. Because any query not will remain. Understood? So suppose some student they are thinking they hear 3d6. So why not here maximum unpaired electron? But our D subshell what they are saying and whatever our rules what they are saying, first singly field and pairing takes place. Understood? So that's why your maximum unpaired electrons in D subshell. Understood? So this small thing you have to concentrate on whatever we are studying in chemistry. Okay, then it become a scoring subject. If you are capturing these small things and you will apply. Okay, now we will discuss question number next, that is question number 11. Okay, so in question number 11, in which of the following series of transition metal ions, all metal ions have 3d2 electronic configuration, 3d2 they want. Okay, so see here you can cross check because already I gave all outermost electron configuration. In that you have to pick out what 3d2 electronic configuration. Okay, so beta here option is what? Small c. So why it is, I am going to explain here. So see, titanium, then what better, vanadium, chromium, and Mn they give, almost in all options they give this only, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese. Okay, so see here beta, you must know their original electronic configuration, outermost electron configuration. So T means what? 3d2 4s2. So vanadium what will come? Yes, Skatti vakra. So 3d3 4s2. So here modify you have to take for chromium. Yes, 3d5 4s1. And for Mn is what beta? 3d5 4s2. Understood? So after this, okay, what will happen? Say beta, we want for those ions. So here small c option, why it is correct? So say Ti+2. Yes, Ti+2. So Ti+2, so these two electron will go now. So what will 3d2 4s0? So V vanadium what they give? 3+. So yes, from this two and one of these electron will goes out. So we have 3d2 4s0, and here yes, chromium 4+1, and from this 3. So 1+3 4, so chromium 4+. 3d2 4s0 you will get easily. And for your what? Mn +5. So these two and these three, so total 5. So what you will get? Yes, you will get what beta? 3d2 4s0. Understood? So you will get, you will understood why this option only. So like that you can cross check other option also. Okay, because I gave outermost electron configuration of that first transition series. Okay, so we will discuss question number next, that is question number what beta? 12. Okay, question number 12. So see in that what they gave, question number 12, what are the values of the quantum number 19th electron of scandium? 19th electron of scandium. So they gave Z is equal to 21. So suppose like that question they gave, so beta, you have to write down full electron configuration, okay, at that time, because they gave specify their 19 electron they want. So see scandium 21, so first you have to write beta here fully whatever electron configuration. So say 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. So say how much count? 2+2, 4+6, 10, 12, 18. Okay. Now here what will come? Yes, for scandium. 3d1. And what beta? Yes, 4s2. Okay. So beta, you got my point here? 2 to 4 plus 6, 10, 12, 18, 19, and 21. Understood? So beta, 19th electrons they want. Okay, so beta, 19th electron, 18 here. So see, one of the most important here, 19 electron in goes where? Yes, 19 electron is goes 4s subshell. Why? Okay, why? Because your whatever your scandium is not your s block element, your scandium is what beta? D block element. So this is your what? 21st, whatever 3d1 is what your 21st element. Okay, as I already told, whatever last electron receiving where? So it is your block number, sorry, block. So D block, so 19, 18 or somewhere they will write like this also. What will happen beta? Energy, jiski energy wo kam ho jati hai 3d1 ke. That's why we are writing before. But actually if you observe different books, So in that 3H2, 3P6, 4H2, 3D1. Suppose you are writing this in this fashion, it is also correct. So we can all easily observe, so beta 19th electron, where in 4H subshell. Okay, so beta, so see here 4 subshell, so n is equal to 4, L is equal to what beta 0 for your S, so 1. Okay, 4 is, so beta at that time your M, whatever magnetic quantum now value 0. Okay, we got 1 only here like this, 4S, 4H2 like this. Okay, so 4S, 2, understood. So 19 electron we want, for means 1 only. So here 4S, 1, if you are, this what will beta 4H2. Suppose if you are considering, if you are writing for 4S, 1, so like that it will come. 4s1, so spin up, so s is equal to what, plus up, so what here, s is equal to plus half, so value where you will get, understood, 19 electron of scandium, so your option is what, small a, your option is small a, understood. So like that, you have to concentrate on this such type of example also. Okay. So beta, must you think here, you know, that is what, where it last electron received, in which block only that element is present. Okay. So 19 electron here beta, 4s1. That's why here 9 is equal to 4, L is equal to 0 for S subshell. And M is equal to also 0 because we already discussed in magnetic quantum number. Okay. Now we will discuss next. Whatever your question number. Yes, 13. Question number 13. So in question number 13, how many number of protons and electrons are present in Ca2+? Proton, yes, 20. Yes or no? Yes. 20 proton. And for electrons, plus 2 means minus 2. So yes, how much it will come? 18 electron, proton 20 and 18 electron, because plus 2 is minus 2. So your option is what beta? Yes, D option, 20 proton and 18 electron. Next, question number 14. Which of the following will have equal number of electrons? So as you know, we will discuss this small b option. Na plus, yes, 11 minus 1, 10. 10 electron, 11 atomic number, plus means minus 1. And for Mg2+, what beta, 12 minus 2, 10 electrons. So which option your small b? So your question number 15, how many electrons are present in chloride ion? So beta, you must know what is a chloride ion. Okay, so Cl minus chloride ion, so 17 plus 1, 18 electrons. So your option is what? Yes, B option, small b option. I hope you understood all this, whatever worksheet in that advanced theory, according to advanced theory we discuss. Yes, what we discussed, D subshell with 21 to 30 electron configuration with the help of inert gas. Okay, I hope you understood all. Okay. So if you have further any doubt, you can send on WhatsApp. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay home. Okay. Thank you.